I got the Vikes 28-24. My first cousin's playing unbelievable, Skip. Completed 70% of his passes, 311 yards, 14.
Wait, you mean Kirk Cousins?
First.
Oh, cousin. I thought you meant DeMarcus Cousins.
No,
I don't
you
know.
Ain't never been to DeMarcus Cousins.
I didn't
no,
know.
No, you didn't.
He's rehabbing unbelievable.
70%,
right?
311 passing yards, 14 touchdowns, 3 INTs, 11th in QBR. Just throw that in for good measure.
You just threw it in? Well, he's only 11th? What's wrong with him?
I know a guy that's 21st.
This is about Kirk
Cousins. Oh, now you want to make it about the topic.
You just said he's playing unbelievable, to quote you.
Yes.
And he's 11th. That means 10 quarterbacks are better than him. Huh.
But here's the thing, Skip. You and I both know there are some teams, you know, there are some players that doesn't have these numbers that has a high QBR. But that's not what we're here to debate. We're talking about the New Orleans Saints and the Minnesota Vikings. I like the Vikes. They're starting to get back. Now, I don't want to put an overwhelming amount of stock in this because the Vikings defense struggled a little bit. Linval Joseph was out last week. I think the starting safety was out last week. I think they're going to get those guys back. But the problem that the Vikings offense posed is unbelievable. Adam Thielen, undrafted. You know, you really have a whole lot of respect for undrafted players, but he's about to do something no other player has ever done. Not go 8 straight. Now, Calvin Johnson went 8 straight, but not it wasn't in the regular. We didn't start the season. This undrafted free agent is about to go 8 straight, 100 yards. And then you got Diggs on the other side. Still got Kyle Rudolph. Now, Dalvin Cook is not going to play that hamstring. They say he's going to be out for a minute. But Murray played well last week, got him 2 touchdowns, had a nice rushing day. So I'm going to take the Minnesota Vikings in a very, very close game. I'm going to say 28-24, but would I be surprised if they got up to, say, 35-34, 35-31? No, I would not, but
wait,
I still doubt
the Vikings. So you're hedging your bet already?
Skip, all I'm saying—
Which is it?
Does it matter as long as I got the Vikes winning? Does it matter if the score is 28-24 or 35-31?
Well, then you could come in on Monday and say, I told you it's going to be 35.
No. As long as—no, I want to come in and tell you I told you the Vikes were going to win.
Oh.
The score is inconsequential to me. I don't work for Vegas.
Oh.
But if you want me to put on my Snake Eye Willie hat, get some of this old stuff over here, I call the game. I give you the exact score, give you everybody numbers if that's what you want me to do, Skip. Because I put on these old hen goggles.
Really?
I get these hen goggles on and can see everything.
Okay. Yeah?
Yeah. That's I see old first cousin with 400.
Do you really?
Yeah, 400.
So your Super Bowl pick to represent the NFC was?
New Orleans.
New Orleans. Oh, the New Orleans Saints.
Your pick
and
too.
A week ago, I stuck right with my Saints to go win at Baltimore, and you said, nope, you're picking the Ravens, right?
Yes.
And then on Monday, I didn't even bring it up, but I think I won that.
You did.
I know it was by hook or crook because maybe the best kicker in pro football missed an extra point.
Yes.
But again, Drew Brees played well enough on the road. That offense played well enough on the road to win the game 24-23. And by the way, just a quick aside on Adam Thielen, you say, I don't have any respect for undrafted, but when you see little white wide receivers, what do you say? Ugh, I can't, right?
No, I love Thielen.
Yeah, you do. I don't think you love Thielen.
Oh, feet.
Yeah, okay. But he is highly impressive. He is shocking me.
Oh, I guess you want him in New England now.
He would fit.
Oh, you think? You think?
Yeah. He might be an even better Chris Hogan, right?
Oh, you think he's better than Hogan?
Well, he's really good. So I'm going to stick with the team that I stuck with before the year. I'm going to pick the Saints on the road once again to win. I'm going to go with the score that should have happened last, whenever it was in the NFC Championship or the NFC Divisional game. I'm going to go with 24-23, which was the score in Baltimore, and it was the score before that fateful last Minnesota miracle play. The Saints were ahead 24-23. So just for good karma purposes, I'm going to say that the New Orleans Saints go back to Minnesota to the scene of the quote-unquote crime and they right their wrong and they hold on 24-23 because I love the way this team is playing football. I told you what jumped out at me at Baltimore was that they ran it 39 times and they threw it only 30 times. Wow.
Mm-hmm.
That'll work.
Yeah.
Because that means you're going to be really good in time of possession, and they dominated time of possession.
Well, yeah, and plus the fact, Skip, you don't want to put your quarterback in harm's way on the road because it's harder for your offensive lineman to hear, and you don't want to subject your quarterback to those kind of hits.
Yeah.
And I'm sure all things being equal, Sean Payton would like to run the ball equally as well as he ran it last week against Baltimore because you know it gets loud in that dome.
It does.
And they start blowing that Viking horn. It could be a little, you know, a little touchy on Drew. But, see, you keep saying, oh, I'm abandoning my pick.
Yep.
I said the Saints were going to go to the Super Bowl. I have them winning. Mm. I didn't say they were going to be 14-2.
Oh, okay.
I didn't say they were going to be 13-3.
Okay.
I didn't say their record, what was going to be their record getting to the Super Bowl. I said the Saints would be the representative for the NFC, and they would win. Mm. See, you get all caught up when I'm picking them, and you're like, oh, you abandoned them. See, that's what you try to do. You try
to
convince.
I don't try to do anything. You're just abandoning ship.
You try to convince my fans, my Lord.
I don't care about your loyalists. They care about me. Yep.
And they say, you be doing a number on Skip. I say, well, I sure appreciate that.
Two of them said that?
They had 200,000
said it. Two of your delusional few followers said you're doing a number. So, the New Orleans Saints are second in scoring, which is really good, but even better, they're second in the NFL in time of possession.
Yeah.
So, that's how they're winning games, because they don't have the best defense. It's 26th in points allowed. I don't know what's wrong with it, but it's not what it was last year. They've had their injuries. Go ahead.
But if you look at all the teams that score a lot of points, their defenses are challenged. Nobody has like a top five or top 10 offense and a top 10 defense. Mm. You notice that? Mm. I mean, look at the Rams. The Rams or Kansas City or New England, New Orleans, with the exception, I think Baltimore might be the only team with the exception has a top 10 offense and a top 10 defense.
Yep.
But for the most part, if you're really, really good offensively, you really, really struggle defensively.
Mm-hmm.
And so you're going to have to win. Okay, who are we? What are we? We're an offensive-based team. We're going to have to win by outscoring people.
Mm.
If we're a defensive-based team, we're going to have to bludgeon you.
Mm. So what is Minnesota? Minnesota is average on offense and average on defense. Wait a second. They're 14th in points scored, and they're 14th in points allowed. So it's blah, blah, right?
No, that's
underwhelming and underwhelming.
That's you taking a shot at you-know-who, Skip. Well, I wish you would stop it, though. It's very unnecessary.
You mean Kurt Cousins.
Kirk.
With
Cousins. A K.
So, Kirk Cousins.
Yes.
With a K is 11th in QBR, as we just pointed out. But here's the stunner. Would you believe that Kirk Cousins has thrown 80 more passes than Drew Brees has? 80 more passes. Yeah. Which means he's plummeted all the way down in yards per attempt, which is kind of an important stat. He's 22nd in the league in yards per attempt because he's dinking and dunking.
I know who's.
You know
I,
what? He's turned into check down Kirk.
I know.
He got replaced by check down Alex in Washington, but he became check down Kirk Minnesota.
I know who has the lower yards per attempt than
Kirk
Cousins.
We're not talking about that. We're talking about Cousins that you put in the Hall of Fame.
I didn't put him in the Skip. All
you
I
have.
Know.
14 touchdowns to 3 interceptions. He's playing, to quote you, unbelievable.
He is.
Unbelievable. He is dinking and dacking. That's what he's doing.
Oh, really?
Dinking
so
and
that's,
dacking. Yep.
Let me ask you a question. You think the Minnesota's upset that they got rid of Case Keenum and got Kirk?
Maybe they will be when it comes crunch time, and you got to make that play to win that game.
You watched the Broncos play.
Who made the decision and the throw that made possible the Minnesota miracle? Case Keenum. Was that not a great choice and a good throw?
Yeah, but the likelihood of you going another season and making great throws like that to come. No, Skip, you got to get consistent play at that position.
Mm.
And what do we start? We're going to talk about Jacksonville later.
Mm.
What's their downfall? They don't get consistent play. If you don't get consistent play, Skip, I don't care how good of skill positions you have.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care what you possess defensively.
Mm-hmm.
If you do not get consistent play from that position, you're not going very far.
Okay.
And the Minnesota Vikings getting great play from that position.
Great?
Yeah.
I don't see great.
I see great. What's 14-3?
You know, you want to talk about greatness? Let's talk about the season that Drew Brees is having, because you know how much I love QBR.
Skip, Drew.
Time out. It's my turn. QBR, Drew Brees, he is almost surpassed the unsurpassable Patrick Mahomes. Patrick is 85.9 for the year. Drew is at 85.5. He just keeps creeping up on him every Sunday. And I think this Sunday he's just going to shoot right by him.
But you have to understand, Pat Mahomes is throwing the ball over people's head. He ain't checking it down.
Oh, okay. Well, QBR says that in just overall effectiveness, that Drew Brees is barely second to Patrick.
If you don't mind me asking, what's the touchdown?
Mm-hmm.
What's yards per attempt?
Drew Brees has 13 touchdowns to 0 interceptions. Is that good?
How many Pat Mahomes have?
Well, I don't know. I'm not
you
talking
do
about
know.
Pat. I don't know. I don't even care. I'm just talking about Drew Brees going to Minnesota.
24.
The scene of the crime.
24.
Okay, fine. That's a whole nother thing. That's a whole nother. They're not even the same conference.
But okay, then why you keep trying to? Who said that Kirk Cousins mm-hmm. is Drew Brees? You keep trying to compare him to one of the greatest quarterbacks ever.
I don't
ever.
Even think he's Alex Smith. Yeah, he's trying to turn into Alex Smith.
You've been in my stash. You know what? I'm going to have to start marking it because you're talking crazy.
I don't sip that stuff that you sip. You just live on that stuff.
Hey, you know.
That's how you get ready for this show. I don't need it.
Yeah,
I got diet.
Because
too.
Sometimes you be talking crazy, Skip, and I have to calm
down. No, I'm not talking crazy. I'm just spitting facts.
No,
right
spitting no
you,
facts.
You got no comebacks.
No, you got
I'm
no facts.
I'm sticking with my Super Bowl pick because I like the Saints.
I haven't gotten off the Saints. I just don't believe they're going to win Sunday.
Hmm.
I didn't say they're going to be 15-1 and 16-0 to get to the Super Bowl. You know, you can get to the Super Bowl, Skip. You don't have to be 14-2 or 12-4.
It helps.
No, it helps getting to the playoffs and winning. That's what helps.
It helps when the Philadelphia Eagles go on a magic carpet ride and they go 13-3 and they get two home games to the Super Bowl. It helps.
Why, Skip?
You know,
I've been a road warrior. I've as a wild card.
Yeah.
I don't mind taking my show on the road. I need the people to see, because they already saw this at home. I need to take this show on the road, let everybody see this. Mm.
Which was the wild card year?
97 and 2000.
Oh. 2000. You had maybe the greatest defense in the history of defenses to hang your helmet on that could carry you home.
Oh, so yeah. Do we get any credit as an offense?
Big play Shea.
Okay.
One play Shea.
That was it. That's all we needed.
Ray Lewis?
Yeah. Oof. We had a nice little squad. Rod Woodson. Yeah. A nice little squad.
Who's that other safety back there?
Woody, Rod Woodson.
Yeah.
But you can't play defense like that now, Skip. So you can't knock people out of the ball game. So it would be a challenge for us to play back in today's game the way we played back then.
Well, I wish the Saints had the 2000 Ravens defense going up to Minnesota, but they don't. So they have to win it with their offense. They have to keep Minnesota off the field.
But when old First Cousins on the field.
Yeah.
You remember Green Bay, Skip, when we needed a drive, we said, Kirk, take us down the field.
Look at Kirk's eyes in that shot. Those are deer in headlights.
No. He's looking
right at him.
But he's coming left.
You can see what's going through his mind.
He's like, I know Thielen on that left hand side. He's getting that work. Let me spare to my right.
I think I'm going to throw a pick.
No.
That's what he's thinking.
No, he's like, I know Thielen getting that work on that backside, but I'm going to stare down Stephon Diggs, move that safety. Thielen, I got you.
So
leading the league in catches and yards.
Minnesota's 4-2-1, but they should be 4-3.
They should be 5-2.
Because
two.
Kirk Cousins threw the interception that ended the game at Lambeau, and he got it erased by the referee. Another robbery.
Personal foul.
A referee robbery.
Personal foul.
Do you have a score prediction?
What's your...
I got it, 24-23.
Okay, 24. What did I have, 28-24, I think.
Well, you were hedging to 35 or something or whatever.
Go ahead
and do 35.
What I say is...
Have the courage of your conviction.
No, all I say, I still have Minnesota winning. I say I can see it like last year. Last year was 29-24. I said 28-24. But would I be surprised if each team scored another touchdown? No, I wouldn't.
Oh, would I be surprised if... The Saints won 42-14? Not really.
Yeah, you would.
Not really.
Skip Bailey, you need to stop.
Well, Lonzo Ball stay in the starting lineup for the Lakers.